Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. I'm going to do another plan with me using my MAMBI sticker book. So I've got the colour story and then I've got two colourful boxes books, but in the end I only actually used one of the colourful boxes books. So I've got my post-it notes on my planner already of just things that I've got going on this week. There's not that much, it's just my general chores and stuff. So I just took the post-it notes off and then I picked up my colour story book and I already knew which of the colourway and designs I wanted to use, but I just flicked back and forth for several minutes trying to decide which of the stickers I wanted. So I did a mixture of the full box stickers. I also used the double box sticker and then some of the smaller ones. First of all though, obviously I have to stick them all over my hand to make myself into sticker hand lady, to make it really awkward to put the stickers down because that is my style apparently. I then just used the full boxes and kind of spread them out throughout the week so that they weren't all kind of clustered together and they were just kind of spread evenly, and also kind of thinking about where I would need to put these actual boxes that I'm putting down now to be able to write my like to-dos and my chores and stuff. So I always have more going on at the weekend because I work Monday to Friday, so I don't have as much time. So I've got a couple of the boxes on the weekend, and then I also wanted just to include some of the smaller stickers as well, just to break up some of the kind of big chunks of stickers. So I put a couple of those down, and then I went back to the colourful boxes book that I have bought recently and that I absolutely love, and I really didn't think I would enjoy using just empty boxes as much, but for some reason I just really like them. They kind of organize everything nicely on the page. I tried to stick to ones that went with the colorway as much as possible, but I'd already used up some other like pinkish red color ones, so I had to go with the brighter pink and the yellow ones, which didn't quite fit, but they don't look totally out of place, so that was fine. So I put some of those down where I knew I had things, mainly just going to the gym actually and doing my runs and stuff. So I put those down throughout the week. And then like I said, I put down some of the smaller stickers, still from that colour story book, so they still kind of go colour wise, just to break it up really and just for decorative reasons. They're not really that functional, I suppose. And then I just carried on going through the colourful boxes book because I just kept thinking of other things that I wanted to put down. So I used a few of the different colours from the colourful boxes book. So I started with the brighter ones, but then like I said, I had run out of the ones that kind of went with this colourway. So I used some from the more pastel range, which they're really nice colours. I'm not sure that they go as well. And it ended up that there's a lot of blue kind of clustered together in the first half of the week and then more of the brighter, darker colours the second half of the week, but that's fine. Doesn't really bother me that much. And then I went through and I found some of the really small icon stickers from the colour story book that just matched the colourway. And I just put those, like dotted those around throughout as well, just to kind of again break up and fill up some of the white space, because there was like a random white space, like Tuesday for some reason. There was a lot of white space there. So actually off camera, I actually added one of the checklist boxes in Tuesday just to fill that in. But this is the finished spread for this week, and I think it looks quite cute, although I am looking forward to going back to using more decorative stickers and less of the full boxes just as a change for next week. But if you've liked the video, please give it a like, and if you want to see more, please subscribe.